Before I start my class, I like to do apologize. I did some mistakes. I did some mistakes, and then I want to make some recovery tonight. Maybe I may not be able to complete that recovery tonight, but I will do my best, and over the next week I will do. So, so my mistake was, if you go to the home page of your course, and then if you go to the content, that actually that there are some learning modules. Okay, I was supposed to follow these learning modules as my lesson plan, but sorry, I inadvertently I overlooked this, so I missed some modules. So that module, okay. Also, another thing that I added a lecture video over here. So this link. So if you go to the lecture video, so then you, I will try my try to like record my lectures, and I will try to upload over here. If you need help to revisit it, or if someone misses a class, then you can come back here and see. Okay, but I was trying to make my lectures and then videos better day by day. So maybe I will do some. Okay. So learning modules one, there were a couple learning modules. There were four things that I was supposed to review for the last 2 weeks. Okay. The learning, the lesson zero, lesson like lecture three, one, lecture two, lecture three, and lecture four. These are the things that you already covered in your CS 13-1. Okay. Thank you. So these are the things that are covered in your 13-21 class. So these are like common things that you already know. So if you please go through these videos in order to be prepared for your quizzes one, two. For your upcoming quizzes, I have extended your quiz due dates. There is no due date in this week, so all quizzes will be due from next week, and then your first test will be following week after next week. So I hope I will be able to cover this by this week and next week. We have another class this week, and then by next week we will cover it. Okay, so if you please go through this, so how do you will do? So if you click over here, and then you will see a PowerPoint presentation like a PDF file. But if you scroll down from right side, scroll down by right bar, and then download from here, click on the download button, then you will download this as a PowerPoint file. So then once you have your PowerPoint file, then you can edit it, you can add some more content for your notes, whatever you want. Okay, so I have already downloaded this, so I want to go through this. And for today, okay, there are also some preloaded videos for sorting and searching algorithm. Okay, so please look these videos. These videos are better than my videos, definitely. So please follow this. And then, so for this one, so is so for today's schedule lecture is lecture 5. Okay, object oriented programming overview. So let me start this. And again, I apologize for my mistakes. So if you need any help, so I'm here. Please email me or see me. Whenever and however I can help you, I will do my best. Okay. So then I will cover my quiz
Sense 1 and quiz 1 for the redo part, these are easy. I think everybody will do. Okay, I have extended time and then I will give some second chance if you need. So in this class, I will cover object, basic concept of objects and classes, and then static methods, bit of a keyword, and something class relationship for this one. So object and class and object, these are the heart. These are this combination of class and object is the heart of object oriented programming. So we understand object. What is an object? In real life, it is an entity, anything, right? And this is an object. But in terms of object oriented programming, we see that there are a lot of. So this is a program. This is a program, an application. It has a lot of objects over here, like taste bar. Button is an object, and the text box is an object, like menu bar is an object. So in Windows program, when like Windows application or operating system, there are some classes predefined, pre-built, and other applications, while developing new applications, many of the pre-built classes can be reused. So this is the main beauty of object-oriented programming, the reusability. Reusability. Once you declare a class, then you can declare or create any number of objects or instance of this class, and also you can extend that class by another class. Then you can reuse that feature. So we will learn those reusability in inheritance chapter, in next chapter. So class, you know, class is actually name, the group of a name. So in plain English, you can identify class as a common noun. You understand common noun better than me, right? So common noun. For instance, here, so the circular, these words are the common noun, and these identify this name group, not a particular person or particular thing. So these are the class. So you see that if you go through the user. Okay, thank you. Slideshow. I'm not sure why it is not showing in full screen. Anybody can help me to show it in full screen? Okay, a class is a name of a group. For instance, if I ask you, what is it? It's a pen, right? And if I ask you, what is it? This is a pen also, right? But these are two different types of pen. In general, these are pen. So this is a pen. When it's a pen, this is a class. And when we bring or use or buy a specific pen, a kind of specific pen, then that is an object. This is an object of pen type. So everything in this world has a type associated with it. Like I am, what is my type? I'm a human being, right? If you do, a type can be subtype to specify more, like I'm a male, right? I'm an adult person. So as you go, you put more attributes of a class, then you will get more specified, a narrow number of items of that class. So that when you specify a specific, a concrete example of a class type, then we say object. So then you know the concept. Why? So how do we declare or we create a class? In our upcoming classes, we will create class. Lot of times we will create class. But these are the basic things. If you understand how to create a class, then it will be easy for you to use class elements and then extend classes. So a class, it has two types of elements. One is data, and another is some functions. Okay. So everything in this class, like for instance, this is a pen class.
These are the elements of paint class. So it has some data. For instance, it has color, it has length, it has weight, it has price. For instance, right? Okay. And so how do we store data? We know that we use variables, right? In general, we use variable in order to store our data. So in class, we will use variable, some variables, in order to store our data. Okay. And then those variables in class are called member variables. Okay, member variables in general. And a class has some methods, some functions. Okay, for instance, the pen, all pens in the world have at least one method or action that we expect that it will write. Right? This pen will write. Okay, write is a method, is a function, is action. So in class, so we say function in different name method. We call all of the function by different name method. So when you see the method, then you understand this method is a member, this is a function, and it is a member of a class. Okay. Now the question is that how, so for instance, this is an example, typical example of a class. What is the class name here? Yes, vehicle. So in general, in current object-oriented programming languages, it is a tradition that you will name your class with an uppercase letter. Okay, so this is why vehicle V is in uppercase. Okay, but if you use lowercase V, then your program will run. Yes, but you know your naming convention, you are breaking your naming convention. So here there are three member variables. What are the three member variables? You see,
door.
Okay, that is a door. It has type or integer, and it has speed and it has color, right? These three, okay, and it has a method. What is that method then?
Run.
Okay. So it has before. So before declare a variable, as we see, we need a type to declare this type, right? This type language. Okay. And then we also need to declare this modifier. This is called access modifier. This private is called access modifier. If you do not access, if you use your private modifier, if you keep it blank, then you consider it as default. So there are four types of access modifier: private, public, protected, and default. So there are some variations over program to program level, class to class level, and package level, and project level. You will know that level, okay, in the standard level. And similarly, this method has, this user type is void, and it has access modifier public. So if a method has a public method, that method can be any public member, the method or variable. That public in its method or variable can be accessed from outside. This is public. Public means outside. You can accept it. Okay. And this is another access modifier for class level. So this class is made public. That means this class also be inherited by another class. We will know inheritance later. Another class, okay? So in every class, you will see there will be at least one public method. In every class, That public method will be used in order to communicate with any object of that class type from outside. So we will know how outside means how far, or what is the boundary. We know the boundary and then we understand the outside. Okay. So this is our class. So if we create a class like vehicle, this will create a blueprint. The blueprint means structure, empty structure. So while creating this building, okay, the architect created a blueprint, right? So like for instance, this blueprint says every vehicle will have doors. It does not say how many doors. Okay. So
So it says every vehicle should run and it should have a speed. It does not say what is the maximum speed. Okay, it does not say, it says every vehicle will have a color. It does not say what color. Color can be given, any color can be given by when we create the vehicle, when we build the vehicle. Okay, so we will see how to create an object of a class.
So let us see, this is another example of a class. So this class, it has class rectangle, right? Rectangle is a class name, right? So how many variables it has? Class members, two, right? Length and breadth, right? So this class name, it says by default, it does not say public or private. This is means these are default. We'll know that different later. Its class also, it does not have access modifier. But a class start with a class keyword and then class name, and this is the class body. It start with angle bracket and it ends with a second bracket or braces. Okay, in some languages like C++, okay, it ends with a semicolon. Class ends with a semicolon, but Java and C++ does not require an ending semicolon. About C++ medium. So how do we create, for instance, we have, once we create a class, then our step will be to create an instance of a class whenever needed. So this line, it says rectangle my rectangle equal to new rectangle. Anyone can help me to explain this? What you are telling this? Who can? Yeah. Yeah, go ahead. Please speak loudly.
Oh, I can explain it. Okay, so
yeah, please.
Okay, so we have to go to. Are we declaring an object or are we doing a class? But so do an object.
Look at here. Look at here. That's a fancy slide.
Okay. So we're declaring. We're creating a rectangle.
Okay. Yes.
So we're gonna name it my rect.
Yes. That's good, awesome. So here you will use at the beginning, you will use class name, type name. For instance, when declaring a variable, for variable declaration, we need a type, right? So for integer or double or float, the same thing we need to give over here. And for class in object-oriented programming, remember that it is different in a way. This type over here, it can be a class, it can be a concrete class, or it can be an interface. We'll know about interface in next 2 weeks. Okay, what is interface and how is it? And here, yeah, we will give like variable name is a class, object name, and then we will use new operator. And then we will use this one is a constructor. This constructor is a method. The constructor is a method that has same name of its class name. Even if do not declare a constructor of a class, object-oriented programming considers that as a default constructor. Yes, okay? So here we do not have any constructor over here, but still it will call this constructor. So, okay, and then it will. So without calling a constructor, we cannot create an object. So now do you know what happens when you create an object of a class? So what happens when we declare a variable? When we create a variable, what happens? Yes. So when we create a variable, for instance, integer x, right? So then in memory, computer RAM, it takes 4 consecutive memory bytes, right? And name the first byte as x. And when you assign value to x, for example, 5, then this value is converted into binary and put on this 4 byte. For instance, this 5 will be put at 101 and then all remaining bytes will be
0000000000. Okay, like this way. Okay, now it's almost similar. Almost similar when you declare a variable. What happens? An object. What happens? Similarly, it will create a space. It will take a space in computer memory. Okay, and for instance, here we have declared a variable hour. Okay, then it will take some spaces. I am not sure yet how many kilobytes or how many bytes or space it will take, but for somewhere it will create space and it will assign name on R1. Okay, sorry, R1. And then now question is that how many bytes it will be assigned? For every variable we know, for integer type it takes 4 bytes, right? For double types or long types it takes 8 bytes, right? For character types it takes 2 bytes. Okay? Then how many bytes it takes for an object type? Yeah. Okay, so how many bytes it has? It has length and width, right? So A. So length has four bytes.
It was double, right? So length will take 8 bytes and then breadth will take another 8 bytes. Okay, so then the question is that will these 16 bytes will be consecuted? Next question. So we will have R1, right? So when you say R1, then R1 will take some memory and then you will see R1 dot length, it will take 8 bytes, it will take 8 bytes, and then in another place, maybe consecutive or somewhere else, it will take another 8 bytes, this is 8 bytes, and it will take another 8 bytes for R1 dot length. You understand? So it will take 16 bytes definitely, but not necessary that these 16 bytes will be consecutive. But it is necessary that this 8 bytes will be consecutive, and another 8 bytes could be either consecutive or integer. But maybe for most of the programming languages, these 16 bytes will be together, like in Java. I don't know all about other programming languages. Okay? So then, what is the function of new? New keyword over here. New is a keyword or you say an operator. So new is the main operator over here. It is very small word, but it does a lot of functions. Okay, it creates a variable and it assigns space. Okay, over here. Okay, so for this here, so it will get length, R1 dot length and R1 dot breadth, but this space initially has no value. Okay, when we assign value, but if you say R1 dot length equal to, so if you say 5, then this 5 will be put in this consecutive in part. And we can see double type, we put 5.0 also, right? Double type, okay. And then when you say R1 dot breadth equal to 5.2, then this 5.2 will take place within this. Okay, and there we'll have some other space between this that will take place for R1 dot, what is that called, run or, what is the method over there? Okay, there is no method for this one, right? Okay, that's okay. But if it has some method, then it will take some other spaces.
So that is the second thing, that is the reference I will come to later. So let us go through this part, okay?
R1 part. And this one is here, rectangle R1. That's for instance, even I say, in the first line I wrote rectangle R1 equal to new rectangle. Okay, here is this is a method, okay? How do you know it is a method, okay? When you see a pair of parentheses, then this is a method. If for every file. Okay, when you see a pair of parentheses,
whether you find something inside the parenthesis or not. This is the method, okay?
And this is something, and when you write rectangle R2, so this is actually a reference. It creates a reference, creates like a reference take a name, okay, but it cannot assign value. For instance, okay, so if I wish to have a baby, okay, if my wife expects a baby, okay, so then it's very common that ahead of the baby born, we will decide a name of the baby, right? We will select a name, right? So then when the baby will born, we will keep the baby that name. We call the baby by that name, right? So what happens until the baby born? Okay, can I get a certificate, birth certificate for the baby? No. Can I get a social security number for the baby? No, right? So at that point is a reference. So here, that so until the baby born, the baby is a reference of a human. When the baby born, then he will be an actual human. Okay, so you understand the difference between reference? So a reference does not take memory space. So until my baby born, he or she will not take space in this world. Right? He will not take any space room in my house or anywhere, right? Okay? So this is the concept of reference. So when you say reference R2, then it does not take any space. Like a baby lies her mother's tummy. For instance, this reference has to depend with some other variable object to name with, to stay with, right? Then if I say R2 equal to R1, okay, because R1 already has stay, right? Then what will happen? These R1 and R2, these R2 will share same space. Like sometimes we have double name, right? We have multiple names with nickname. For instance, you can understand reference by a nickname, or you can understand a reference by an unborn baby. So you understand that? Now you understand, do you understand this, by this line? So then we can write this line together as this. Rectangle R2 equal to R1. So that means you can put value for R1, not R2. So whatever value you can put for R1, that value will be same for R2.
Okay.
You understand? I have a nickname, for instance. XYZ, my nickname. I have my social security number as my legal name. Okay? But my social security number, I can say, it goes according to my nickname as well as my, not officially nickname, but unofficially it goes to my nickname, right? Number. Same thing. You understand? You see that these R2 is empty.
Yeah.
These R2 does not take any memory space, but it shares with something. You understand the difference? So with thumb drive we will use reference, okay? In some situations. The reference is used a lot. If you want to, like for instance, if you have a chance to get modify your variables or object, so then you keep a copy. Sometimes we use same variable, right? For swapping. So why use same variable? To hold the previous value, right? Sometimes you use reference variable like to reference to hold the old value. So similarly, it is same for another variable. It's same that is for swapping, everyone use, right? Any questions at this point? So what is the function of new operator? Without new operator, is it possible to create an object? No. About all the object oriented programming languages, they use new operator. And what is this here? This here, rectangle. This. What is this kind of name? Nice name. It has a color, it is called constructor, right? The constructor constructs an instance of this class type. And this type may be rectangle or it could be parent. Parent means reference. So we will know about that later. Okay? So then how object allocate memory is here from the sixth class, and then we create an object. This object takes place, for instance, object one takes place over here, and when you create another object, then that object takes another place. Okay, two objects take two different places in memory. No objects here unless there are references. Okay, so once every time you create an object using a new operator, then it will take a different memory, independent. Okay, but without memory, without new operator, it becomes a reference and it will not take a new step. Okay, then the question is that, so all objects take place in computer heap. You understand heap, right? Heap stack. Did you see this in previous class or in, did you take any different stack about computer type in the class? So heap stack, those are memory type, data, which is a data structure. Maybe I'm not sure that heap, I have to go about heap and then stack, like array. These are data structure. Array, linked list. We have array, linked list, that's right. You know that, right? So did you work with linked list? Okay. Linked list. Okay, so linked list is type of array. Array type is a data structure. So heap, all objects take memory place in heap. So here you see that I'll take like this way. So for storing integer and then storing name, marks, and then alpha. Okay, so I already mentioned object versus reference, right? What is the main difference between an object and a reference? An existing object. Reference relates to an existing object, right? Reference is, you cannot use a reference independently. Because I want you assign value, okay, then it will tell you. Unless you assign a reference by another existing value, then you cannot use it. This is reference. Like for instance, when you say that int x, y, int x, comma, y. So both x and y are integer type, right? And then if you say x equal to 10, if you say x equal to 10, right? Then we know that x equal to 10, right? But now if you say y equal to x, then what is the value of y? Yes. Something, right? You are not assigning value y, but directly this is indirect assignment. This is like y is similar to reference. Yeah? Okay. Now, even if you change this value x, for instance, if you change this x value x, if you say x equal to plus or plus equal to 2, then what will be x? X plus equal to 2.
Well.
Yes, then x will be 12. At this point, what will be y?
No,
X. Y. Still it is 10. Right? Okay? So then, okay, because, but it is, but unlike a reference already changed. If it is a reference, it is not reference. Okay? This is variable, independent variable. This X and Y, this takes different independent memory space. Okay? But reference, this is not like this. There is a difference between I told you reference is like a temporary variable, but not exactly variable, right? Because reference does not take memory space. So if you change the original object, reference will be changed also. Value of the reference will be changed. Because for instance, I told you I have a nickname. That nickname is my reference. Okay? If my social security number changes, okay, or my address changes, right? Still my nickname's address will be changed, right? Some of my friends, they know me by my nickname. If I go to a different place, different home or apartment, so my friends, old friends will come to my nickname and then they will look, go to my new place, okay? Same thing is the reference.
So how objects communicate? Objects communicate with each other through message passing. How do we communicate with each other? Like human being, I am an object, right? And you are an object. So how do I communicate with you?
Speaking.
Yes, speaking is a message passing. Because I, as a human, I have an action, speak. Right? Then my action, I communicate with you, you are another object. So then I communicate with you through our common message, or common able message. That message can be reused or modified. We will go through that later. Okay? So objects communicate with each other through message passing. Okay, there are some members. For instance, here, yeah, let me go back to this class. So this class, okay, this class, this length and breadth, these are regular variables. Okay, regular variable. Okay, but there are another kind of variable. So these regular variables are accessed through each object. So I cannot access length independently. I have to use object, then dot operator, object dot length. That means length of this object, breadth of this object. Okay? But for most of the time, you will see method or members of a class are accessed through each object using dot operator. But there is an exception. The exception is that static member. If a member is declared as static, that is global. That becomes global and that becomes a common value for all instances of this class. For instance, all of you here are a student of KFC. Right? All of you are here as a student of KFC, right? You are a common institution, KFC. Now if I declare a variable, so I want to make all of you school name, college name, okay, KFC. If I declare it as a static variable, then I can say, I don't need to define or initiate your college as KFC, his college as KFC, his college as KFC, or independently. So I can give a common name. Common value, okay? That common value is given by static modifier. So once you static, then that will be global. And in that case, for a static, that is called by its class name. For instance, if it is class, that means it's well and global. For instance, for now, if someone says, okay, so Donald Trump. So even as a small baby in my country, they know. He or she knows that Donald Trump is the president of America. Well known, right? A well known figure. If you say Barack Obama, so everybody knows that he was the president of USA. So if we say US, Barack Obama of US, right? So then globally, he is known as the former president of USA, right? So that is actually, he is like kind of static figure. So in order to access static figure, we do not need to use actual and instance of variable, of object. We call that by class one. Because although there may have like hundreds or thousands Barack Obama in USA, yes.
So if you have multiple objects
in
the same class, if you have them
here, when you got admitted here, yes, KFC, right? All of you have got your institution, university name, college name of SKAC, right? It will not be changed. Right? It will not be changed. The same thing, it is a common thing that applies to all members of this family. So this is why, like for instance, sometimes we use static method or static members a lot. For instance, here, this static modifier is the math dot square. So how to, there is a good way to remember what is, which one is class and which one is method. I told you that to, in order to know that this is a method, after the method name, there will be parentheses, right? So that depends. If you see something within parentheses, then this is argument. Okay, but sometimes you will see there is no nothing in argument. It may have something or may not have nothing. And then, so before the dot, if you start with an uppercase letter, then it's a class. All class by default convention start with an uppercase. So when you call math dot square 25, then it will, everybody, so even you will, please remember that d square is a static method. And this is defined within math. Okay? But if it was a non-static, then it could be different. For non-static, well, if I say, for my rectangle class, if I would say that static double length, then this length would be same for all instances. I cannot change this length. So something you will see, static integer count over here, that will be counted the same. So sometimes we will use this count to see how many variables or objects are being created for this class. Sometimes we may need to keep that interest. How many classes are being created for this class? There are some situations that call a singleton class that allows to have only one of per class. See, a singleton class does not allow to keep a second object. So in that situation, it takes track of how many instances are created. Okay? So there is another way that someone mentioned. That is called, we use find static final in order to declare, a constant in Java, maybe in C# as well. We use static final. Static final means, the final is a keyword, static is another keyword. With the combination of these keywords, we declare a value, a variable, like a named constant. with a fixed value that cannot be changed at runtime. You understand? A program running has two steps. One is compile time and is runtime, right? Compile time means in like Eclipse, when you type in program code, it automatically compiles. Every time, as soon as you create a character, it compiles within a millisecond. This is why you do not realize. But when you run it, then you will get the runtime result. So compile result, so for Eclipse is good enough that it creates, it takes, compiles within a few milliseconds. Okay, as soon as it is mistake, it shows you. So local variable cannot be static. The static must be global because local variables are used for a local function, local method. Okay, for instance wise. But static variables are used globally, so this is why static variables always be global. So here is this tuple class is a static. Sorry, tuple method is a static method. We are familiar with another static method, right? What is the most common static method in Java? Yes, main method. Every like Java program or every project should have a starting point, right? When you run the project or run the program, there should have a starting point where the program would start from there. So main method is Java is a threading, multi-threading programming language. Unless you declare multiple threads, it has only one thread, main thread. And main thread starts with main method. And main method is a public static void main. Static means within a class you put main method, but for calling main method, a static method, you do not need to create an object. When you run, compiler automatically creates object of that class and runs the static class. So here we see the how we are using helper, class is helper, then we are calling hello equal to helper dot 3458. Maybe here what is written here, it is multiplying the given number 5 by 3. Okay, class relationship, this has a dependency, aggregation, and inheritance. We will know this later. You write it down. Okay, dependency, but for instance, in other word, we use it, and for aggregation, we use has it, and for inheritance, we use is it. So I want to show this in a block diagram, so that quickly you can understand. Let me show you in a block diagram, okay? So object relationship. There is a good, you can go through this, but you know, so this is a, it says author writes book, okay? I have, okay. So there are two kinds of association in class level. It's called like aggregation and composition. Okay, for instance, and association. Okay, so association is the highest level. There it has another two sub levels. It's called aggregation and composition. There is a tiny difference between aggregation and composition. Okay, there is a minor difference. Let us try to understand. So it is easy for you, you can go through the slide and you can use that thing. The thing is that, what is the relationship between a car and a driver? Right? Usually, a driver drives a car. Right?
One driver pumps
car, right? And usually, a car is driven by a driver. In opposite order, we say. Right? So then, what is the relation between car and driver? One to one. Not has a level. So I'm coming here. And this association can be divided into two: aggregation relationship and composition relationship. Composition relationship, for instance, a car has an engine. Okay, a car has an engine, and maybe and this is. This is composition and aggregation. Aggregation means a CD contains some songs. If you have a CD of song, right? It contains some songs, right? Okay? But think about the difference between these two, between aggregation and composition. Difference is minor. Please give attention, okay? Difference is that if you take out the engine from your car will be disabled, right? Unused, useless, right? So if engine is like damaged, then your car is supposed to be damaged, right? It's valuable. Okay? But if you take off Samsung, like if you there, I told you there are consider that there are multiple songs in a CD. But if you delete one song, still you will have some remaining songs. If you delete next song, then you may have some other songs. If you delete all of the songs,
then you no longer have any songs.
But you may have the CD. You will have the CD. Yes.
Yeah. So if one class has a composition of another class,
yeah,
that means that class has a composition is
integration.
It's like part of it and it's
yes, it's part of it. It's the core part.
It's required to
be yeah.
For that class.
Yes.
If it's aggregation, it's just like any other branch.
Optional. If it's aggregation, then it is optional. And you see, maybe you sometime you will use UML. UML is a tool, unified programming language, that I drew this picture with UML. UML is a tool that is used to draw, and then you can write your code. You can generate your code. I use UML with Python. Any of you, if you use Python, then you can use UML. UML is a free tool. Okay. So so that means yes, you're right. So for aggregation, this part you see that the symbol between aggregation is hollow over here, right? The diamond is hollow, right? But for composition, the symbol is solid. Okay. So this is one to one. That means this car has one car has one engine. Okay. So if the engine is taken out, then the car is visible. But this is said 1-2-star. You see, star means many. So that means this CD has more than one song. So if you take out one song, the CD will have other songs. But if you take out all of the songs, you have CD. Maybe you can reuse that for other purposes. Other things, okay? So this is the main concept of integration and composition. Now, if you please add this slide, now if you please go to previous slide, then it will be easy for you to understand the difference between aggregation and composition. So, you will need these concepts in order to be a software engineer. When you will develop or design your application, then you will use it. In order to write small programs, you will have. So this there is a Venn diagram shows that every composition is an aggregation or association, right? But association, every association is not an aggregation. So this diagram says. Okay, so there is a reference, it's called this reference. These all in lower case, this reference. This reference is used, some of you will see in Java, in Python you will see me. Who knows Python over here? See me, maybe. In some languages they use self. Maybe in C sharp they use self, right? Python is me, right? Self? Okay. Which language use me? Some languages use me. Okay, these are self. Okay, so each denotes the current object. It denotes the current object. And why is needed to use, sometimes it is essential to use this keyword. So when it is needed to this object? If you see some, this is, what is this? Is this a class or is it a method? Yes, maybe it is a constructor, right? So it is upper case, so it's a constructor. So these constructors, we refer that this class name is actual. Okay, so these constructors, this class has an top list that is not shown here, some reference variable, member variables as name, account number, and balance. Okay, but if your name, account number, or balance, they have same type, and if they have same name, so it has here, it was name, and then after that, it has arguments there. Okay, so that it has account number and it has account number. So each a method, okay, constructor is a method, contains some arguments that are same name of each class level variables. Then we have to use this. But if these names are different, then we don't need to use this. When I go, yes.
So for this dot name, that's referencing to the property of the class?
No, I'm coming. Property, not. Okay, I'm coming. So this dot name is the property of a class. I'm coming. Okay, so with an example, with a better example. Okay, yeah. So this class, okay, so this class has double length and bridge, right? So let us consider that this class has another method called fifth dimension. Okay, let us consider that this class has another method as fifth dimension. Okay, so then if we want to declare, so this math says fifth dimension has an integer different, right? Actually, so
I can fix it quickly. Give me a second, please. Like it will be like this. Int and void set dimension int length. Okay, for instance, okay, let me do this int, in order to length I put ln and br. Okay, if I have this different name of DRS, okay, if I have this, then this is the same name, which is the field name, and this is the argument name are same, then I have to use this, like this dot ln equals to ln, okay? But if it is a different name, okay, different name, usually it was a different name, right? It was, previously it was int length, it was this, right? So in that case, it is optional. In that case, so you have different name over here, length, and this length is associated with this. When we assign a value, right? When we say rectangle R1 equal to new rectangle, and then R1 equal dot set dimension 2010, then this 20 will be set to the L. And this 10 will be set to BR. But if you have a different name, okay, variables name are different over here, length and breadth, but over here you have ln and breadth, in that case this using this is optional. But if I would declare this one as length and this one as breadth, then I must have used this one. Otherwise you will see error. Yes. When the field name and arguments are never same, then you have to use this. You remember quickly the main concept to understand this. But if you use different name over here, it's different, then optional. So what does this operator do? This operator refers to the current object. For instance, over here, let us see the example. Let us try to understand this one. So here we have a public class my number, right? Okay, so this has a local variable integer x equal to 3. And it has another public method, say set x. Okay, this set x method has another local variable. So this is, what is this called? Field, right? Okay, member variable of field. Okay, and this x is a local variable. This local variable. So when you print x, then what will be printed? 4. That's because it will print local variable. And when you print these dot x, it will be 3. So you understand how this is used? Okay, this is one use of this. There are some other use of this. This operator is used to call the constructor of child constructor. When we study about inheritance, we will see that. Okay. So you know that this is the assignment variable equal to the assignment variable, right? Assignment variable was same way that we know from your other class. That for instance, before num1 and num2, if num1 equal to 5 and num2 equal to 12, then after, if you say num2 equal to num1, then that will be replaced, right? Then num2 will be replaced by num1. So these are three. I'm almost done for this one. And like for instance, maybe it has same thing for object. Same thing for object reference. This is actually alias. Reference is another, it has another name, alias. Reference is another name, alias. That is called like unique. So these are the things that lecture 4. Now I want to spend some time to review other lectures that I missed. I apologize for that, my mistake. Okay. I want to go through this just to quickly so that you can be prepared for your upcoming quizzes. Okay, I have extended the quiz and you have your test quiz on. Okay, so these are the common data types, right? Common data types in Boolean, in C sharp we say bool, bool, but in Java we say Boolean, and in Java we say string. In uppercase. In Java, string is an object. Okay, so this is why string is not a data type, a special data type. Okay, an object. But in C sharp, you will see string is in lowercase. This is the difference. Okay, and everything in Python is an object. So in Python, you will not see character, char. Python, there is no character type. Okay. The character type is used to assign a single character. That is a class, okay? So this is the common thing, how do you declare a variable? So this is the common thing that sometimes even I do mistake, that in order to declare a float type variable, we have to give an array. Sometimes I do mistake, okay? Then luckily I get an error message from my compiler, and then quickly I can fix it. Okay, but for double type, you don't need to get F. Okay, and for float type, it takes 7 digits. Okay, after decimal point, it takes 7 digits. And maybe double, for double type, maybe it has 13 digits. I'm not sure, maybe you can check for double type, but for float type, maybe it has 7 digits. After decimal point, it shows 7 digits after, by default. So this is for console. You know about this for C sharp, the write method and then write line method. We use this. Maybe you can go through this. This is for Java. And data validity and accuracy. That as I mentioned in previous class, when assign value to a variable, we need to be careful about range, right? For anyhow, we cannot exceed the range. Like if we exceed the range, or program exceed the range, then we will disaster, the program will shut down. Maybe a few years ago, I saw that it happened in NASA. The programmers, they wrote a program and then the aerospace crashed. Because there was a value, maybe to the speed or something, for some operation that exceeded its range. Okay, so that is one garbage value and then that. So this is why we need to get. To be careful and learn how to declare data type and then it's important. But when we declare, for instance, if we want to assign 1000 for X, right? We will not use comma, right? Comma, if you use comma, then what will happen? No, it will consider three things. One is one character, thing like a token, comma is another token, and this is another token. See? Like comma is a separator, so then it will be confusing which value it will take, this one or this one. So we will not use comma, right? Even for decimal number. Although in traditionally we use a comma after every 3 digits. So you know how to write pseudocode. Yeah? I thought some of you master. Okay, so these are the conditional operators. So you know all of these. So if or is and else if this
these have a condition over here, right? If the condition is true, then this statement is true. If you have multiple statements, then you have to use the parentheses. Sorry, you are starting that, right? To block. If you have multiple statements over here, then you have to use the curly bracket. But for single statement, curly bracket is optional. Closing with the second bracket is optional. Okay? But I want to here emphasize here one thing that you know already for switch operation. For switch operation, like case uses, switch operation starting from Java 7, switch operation use. Allowed to use any kind. It is a type, float type, or string type. Variable for it will be switch. So in switch, what is switch? Is there an example for switch? Okay, maybe. Okay, then do. Okay, so anyone can tell me that what is the difference between do while and while?
Do while
and
do it
at least
once while it is failed at its first attempt.
Yes.
Do while can have an iteration counter to zero.
Okay.
Oh, wait.
No.
While.
Yes, opposite. Why do while at least execute the body at least one time? After execution, it takes the condition over here, right? So then, even if the condition is false, then you jump down on the leader body on time, right? Okay, so then do while will execute the body at least one time, even the condition is false. And why it will change the condition first when it comes here in the while. So why it will change the condition first if and only if the condition is true, then it will execute the body. Okay? So then there is another tiny difference between while and do while is that after while you do not use semicolon, but after do with do while, with do while after while you use semicolon. There is a tiny difference in syntax level. Do you remember now? You remember? Yes. Oh, that is done. Okay, for the next one, I'll go through the next step and then we'll. So we have a few more minutes. Can you spend a few more minutes, please? Okay, started for you. Okay. So this is class is an array. So array. Okay, so I already covered constructor and then instance variable. So here, get and set is greater than setter. We will know that later, okay? Greater than setter are used to assign handles to instances. Okay, so this is a class, and then this class has constructor. Okay? It's a good example here. I see. You see here, it is private team name, and it has points. Integer point and it has string A and C. So there is no D. Because this is optional, you can use D over here, but it is not required, okay? But tell me the situation when this will be required. Yes, if this name is the same as this, if programmers use like these as name, not A, okay? Then you will put this dot name equal to name, okay, this name, this right side value will refer to this, and this value will refer to the top one. This is a good example of avoiding this keyword, okay. So getter and setter are used. So how do you remember getter and setter? You know, I remember this way. So getter, I see getter, G E double T E R, right? I remember this one.
get or return thaki. I read opposite way. Getter R-E-T.
Returns, right? I remember this way. So it was still, it was sometimes for a long time confusing for me.
Which one returns the value and which one does not return the value. You see that what I'm going to talk about here? There is getter and setter. This is a C sharp code. Okay? So here, getter always return the value. So I remember this way. I write getter. So then after get, I read from opposite direction. Getter return. So this way for a long time I remember. What getter and setter is. Okay? And setter set value. So after how getter and setter work, you will see program. But you have to set value first and then you have to return. You have to get, call getter first and then you have to use setter later. So in Java, okay, so string is an object. Object type, string type, okay? So in programming language, sometimes you see in annotation, this is an annotation, at the rate you are overwrite. So if overwrite or overloading, we will see in next class, but there is in programming language, sometimes we use special characters. This is not this line, it's called annotation. Okay? So if you please go through this page, and then you will see array, and then everything you see, and then next week I will give you the value part. Okay, so click you can take the quiz one, and if you need help, then let me know, and then if you need to recheck, click the thing.
Thank you so much.